Whether you think of it as 2021 or pandemic year two, the state of the world over the last 12 months has had a huge impact on our listening habits. In uncertain times, we queued up some old faves. Albums loaded with nostalgic bangers from Fleetwood Mac, Nirvana, Queen, Guns N' Roses and The Beatles topped the list of classics we streamed a whole heap in 2021.
People are longing for a different time, a pre-pandemic Lockie Day time, and getting into that nostalgia as well.
Plants were also an unexpected big winner as green-fingered hobbyists grew the number of listeners on Spotify's Soothing Music for Plants playlist by 1,400%. Of course, music isn't the only thing we stream these days, and podcasts went off. For Aussies this year, it was true crime, hard news, and COVID updates, and the controversial ivermectin-injecting libertarian dude bro Joe Rogan.
It will eventually get to straight white men are not allowed to talk.
Australians still love other Australians. We saw Daniel Johns pipping Joe Rogan on the local Spotify charts.
But these lists are all about the music, and in 2021, pop was the pandemic panacea. In Australia, Taylor Swift chalked up the most streams and Heatwaves by Glass Animals was the number one track. The Kid Laroi was the most streamed Aussie artist.
Taylor Swift absolutely crushing the charts this year once again. And I think a lot of it is just showing how strong and unfailing her listening base and her fan base is.
Globally, there were megatons of international star power streamed on Spotify this year. But three titans dominated. Puerto Rican rap prince Bad Bunny, pop princess Tay Tay, and K-pop kings BTS.
BTS has obviously had a meteoric run in the last couple of years. They are probably one of the biggest artists and biggest groups in the world.
Something like Spotify's Wrapped has really helped us move away from the term guilty pleasure. I think people are really proud of what they listen to now.
Of course, the best part of this new annual tradition is unwrapping your own top tracks and inflicting them on your friends. So go on, who made your top five?
I can reveal around the office the most streamed artist in the project office was Taylor Swift.
Really?
Which kind of surprised me because I thought most of our co-workers thought they were hip and wouldn't listen to what everyone else was listening to.
Yeah.
But apparently that's all a front.
Well, she had those, she released those two albums, which are more of an indie albums, didn't she?
So you think that
the
gives...
guys from The National, who were one of my favourite bands, they were fantastic albums. And then she did the red one recently. So
the
she
red
had a big
one.
Year.
Yeah,
great album.
Yeah, great. Yeah. The other thing I can reveal is that some of the dads in the office are listening to Do You Want to Build a Snowman from Frozen.
And no, I'm not surprised by that, actually. That's a beautiful
catchy.
Tune.
It's a catchy
song. It's very catchy. Mm. We have a bit of Frozen on in our household.
That's in your list.
And Christmas is coming.
That's my bag.
That's right. Almost become like a Christmas carol.
Yeah. Oh. Sadly, we also had some dads listening to Anaconda by Nicki Minaj. It's not a sweet.
No. You know, swings and roundabouts.
Swings and roundabouts. We've got all kind of guys in our office.
Tell me the lyrics. I'm not familiar with the lyrics.
I forget the lyrics. Don't listen to it. I listen to the Snowman one.